Well, I mean, we're definitely looking for a whole team effort, and I mean, this is what you work for all year, and you know, of course, you put a lot of emphasis on dual meets, but everything is a process towards building toward, you know, this tournament and wrestling your best at this tournament. And so, you know, certainly Mitch Isles been one of our leaders and our most dominant wrestler this year. So we're definitely looking to get him through to the national tournament. I think after that, there's a number of guys that are going to have a great opportunity, might take an upset here or there. I think Dean Arevalo should be right in the mix at 125. 141 is a weight class, I think, after the first two, three guys kind of opens up a little bit. Jared Sublett, we certainly haven't seen his best wrestling yet this year, but he's had some setbacks with injuries and things like that, and I think he's going to be ready to wrestle really well here for us this weekend. You know, we've had some great efforts out of Tanner Chrysler and Keegan Barry lately, and they've been in, you know, right in the mix with guys who are going to end up being three seeds or four seeds, and so that's the type of match we got to find a way to win.
How about Keegan? He's won 8 out of his last 10 matches. What has he kind of done recently that's helped him get on the W side of things?
He just kind of keeps working on the little things. He does a good job of, you know, when he struggles with something in a match, he does a good job of you know, actively trying to fix it. And so he's just kind of gotten stronger and stronger throughout the course of the year, and I think he'll be, you know, be ready to compete at his best here this weekend. And he's, you know, it's going to be, he took a couple tough losses this season that were really close matches, and those are the type of match where if he can turn it around, he can be in contention to be a national qualifier.
Mitchell in particular just had the big night, broke the school record for wins. How much would it be really special to end his career by sending him to nationals this weekend?
Yeah, it would be great, and it's the expectation at this point. We definitely want to get him in the top two if we can, if not win this tournament. And it's, we want more than just a national qualifier out of him. We want an All-American. And potentially even push him to be a national champion. I think he can wrestle with anyone in the country. And so I think he finished the season as number two ranked in the region. So he's got that capability, and you know, we're definitely looking forward to coaching him in a couple weeks in Iowa.
How about the level of competition? Is this going to be the toughest you've seen this year?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've intentionally made our schedule a little bit tougher this year than we have over the past couple of years, to try and see teams, like, you know, when we went out to Pennsylvania, we saw five teams out there that are going to be pretty comparable to what we'll see this weekend, and so I think we know the level of competition is going to be tough. It's probably the toughest region in the nation, and so I think our guys are ready for that based off of what we've seen throughout the year. But yeah, it's a grind of a tournament, and you got to really be consistent. You got to be persistent, and if you take a loss, it's got to be a short memory and get ready for the next one. And it takes a lot of toughness to make it through this tournament.
You have a lot of young guys on your team, and you got some seniors that are leaving. Are you going to have the arsenal to fill those big shoes? And you've already got some guys who are young that are doing very well.
Yeah, we're excited about our young group, and it's just going to be really important that they continue to improve in the off season. They got to have a good off season to be ready to fill in some of the shoes. I think we'll be sending three seniors in our starting lineup. Carlos, Riley, and Mitch will all be starting for us this weekend at the region tournament. So those guys aren't easy to replace, but we've already done quite a bit of work on, you know, we've seen it coming, so we've done quite a bit of work on trying to get guys in that are going to be ready to replace them, and we may address some of those weights in the recruiting process still yet this year as well.